Breakfast is the most important part of the day. It's my favourite part of the day or meal to eat out. But you don't always get to do it. Sometimes you're in a bit of a rush. On the weekends you get to eat out, but not so much during the week. But you can still have a cafe breakfast at home, make it yourself, and it's as good as what you would eat if you ate out. So I'm going to show you how to make a little smashed avocado, cold smoked salmon, open sandwich, I guess is the best way you describe it. Now, eggs are one of those things that everyone has different methods for and you try and get right. One, make sure your egg is at room temperature. Don't take it out of the fridge and then put it into boiling water. Two reasons why. One, there's a chance you'll crack the shell on the outside and it's obviously gonna change the cooking time. So this is at room temperature. So I'm gonna lower it gently into our boiling water. So as soon as these go in, I'm gonna set my timer for 4.5 minutes. And when you take them out, I've got a little bowl of cold water here. Refresh them in cold water to stop the cooking process. Otherwise, you're gonna overcook them. So we can move on to other things while that's happening. I'm gonna make my smashed avocados. So my avocados, you're going for ones that are nice and ripe. So you can see these are sort of purpley, dark, almost black with little flecks of green through them, which shows you they're at the ripe end of their life cycle. And if you squeeze at the top here, they should be nice and soft. Open them up. Take out the stone, get a spoon, and just scoop out the flesh straight into a bowl. Now if you get them and they're not ripe, they're really green, they ripen via temperature or ambient temperature in the room. So put them in a warm room, you put them in a brown paper bag to help warm them up if you want to, and that will speed up the ripening process. So an avocado doesn't ripen until it's taken off the tree, and then it ripens via ambient air temperature. So you can leave it on the tree for as long as you want and it won't go soft. Once you take it off, then it will go soft. If you want to slow that process down, obviously put it in the fridge, cool it down, and it will stop it ripening quickly. So in with that, I want the zest of half a lemon and the juice of a whole lemon. It's going to stop our avocado going brown, so it stops that oxidization of the sugar in the avocado. Put that in, juice of our lemon. Nice pinch of salt in there as well. Avocados love salt. Then some Persian feta. Persian feta is the soft feta. So it's sort of like a marinated feta. Pop that in. And then you just want to grab a fork and mash it all together to create our smashed avocado. You want it to be nice and chunky. You still want texture in your avocado. You're not making a puree. It is a smashed avocado. And then I'm going to pop in with that some chives as well. Probably about a tablespoon of finely chopped chives. Pop that in. Mix that all together. That is my smashed avocado. That is a really versatile recipe too. You use that as a dip if you want to do. You dip crackers in there, carrot sticks, celery sticks. Avocado is great because it's a really good carrier of flavor. It has lots of good fat in it. And it carries flavor really well. Now I'm going to toast my bread. Toast my sourdough in a griddle pan. So I can turn my pan on, drizzle them with some oil. So into our griddle pan, eggs are done, straight into cold water to stop that cooking process. Peeling your eggs is one of the most annoying things in the kitchen, but someone showed me a magical way of doing it. So you've got a little jar, you half fill the jar up with water, put your egg in there, put your hand over the top. You're gonna take this over the sink because I'm gonna make a mess. Then you just shake it back and forth and the shell comes off. Does anyone really think this is gonna work? Okay, well it didn't work. Well, that didn't work exactly how I wanted it to, but the shell did come off and you can see the shell on the bottom there and the egg is peeled of the shell. But because we've soft boiled these, it means that the center is quite delicate. If you are hard boiling your eggs, I reckon that'll work. So next time we do a hard boiled egg recipe, I'll use that. But I'm gonna have to do it the old fashioned way. So tap it gently. And then peeling into the water. And you'll pretty much be able to tell the moment you start peeling it whether or not it's nicely cooked. whether you've gone a little bit over or a little bit under, by the give in the egg. So you want it to be quite pliable in your hand because you want that yolk to be nice and runny. All right, so there's my two eggs. My toast is done. I'll use this plate to plate up. So grab out our charred rabbits, a little rabbit. Cold smoked salmon is a great little breakfast treat because you can have it in the fridge. You don't really have to do anything to it apart from open it up and then get stuck into it. So I'll peel off some sheets of that. Now I've got everything that we need to plate up our dish. So put one of our cold smoked salmon on top of our toast. Then I'll load that up with our smashed avocado. And then I want to put the egg in the middle of that. A few little pieces of parsley around the plate. So that is our smashed avocado with cold smoked salmon. And this is our dressing that goes with it. So that little gooey egg yolk, a little sprinkle of salt, some cracked pepper, some of our garlic oil, and that is it. Nice little breakfast. I reckon 10 minutes from start to finish to put it together. If you get up 15 minutes before your gorgeous wife or your lovely husband, spend that 15 minutes wisely and make them breakfast in bed.